There's a big old smudge on my lens. So as you can tell, I'm not in the studio and I'm not in my apartment. I'm not even in Quebec, actually. I'm in BC. I'm on vacation. Yes, even I need to take a break. Today's video is all about casual photography and casual videography. This craft that I'm very passionate about, it gets in the way sometimes. And sometimes it's really hard to separate work and your personal life. And these are just some of the things that I have been thinking through while I'm out here in BC on vacation. And I think it's really important that we have a good, healthy work-life balance. It's good for your mental health and for your physical health. I've seen this happen to myself dozens of times. I just took this beautiful walk with my family and my friends. I was so obsessed with getting good footage and videos that I never actually enjoyed the view and looking out at everything because I was seeing it all through this little tiny viewfinder, this little tiny screen, and that's what you want to avoid. But then there's also the other side of the spectrum where we decide, you know what, I'm not even gonna bring my phone or my camera, I'm not gonna take it out, and I'm just going to enjoy this experience. Really, it needs to be 50-50. You should spend half your time actually enjoying the environment and actually appreciating the space that's around you, and the other half you should actually be taking great videos and photos. You're going to have better memories of the experience, so those pictures and videos that you took will actually mean more to you because you were there, you experienced the whole thing, rather than just being like, oh yeah, I took this amazing picture. And then it ends there. That's not the kind of photographer or videographer I wanna be. I wanna be able to tell stories and have good memories from the footage and from the pictures that I take. But here are just some of my tips and suggestions that I've been trying to implement as I'm on this great trip in this wonderful province. So my first suggestion is to travel with really casual gear. Now this can mean several different things to several different people. Maybe you have a really nice camera, but it's a better idea because you'll enjoy the trip more if you just travel with your phone and just take photos and videos with that. Maybe that means that you're traveling really lightweight and you're only gonna be using like one or two zoom lenses instead of like 10 prime lenses that only cover one focal length. This trip, I'm actually carrying the kit lens. I have Sigma Art lenses that are beautiful and they're sharp. They have like a 1.8 or 1.4 aperture. They're beautiful and I love them. I'm able to use this zoom lens, which is not the brightest. It only goes down to like 3.5 at 12 millimeters, but it has a really nice zoom. And even though it's not the sharpest, it will get me the result that I'm happy with because I'm not running around with all of these different cameras and swapping lenses and carrying around this really heavy camera bag. No, instead I have two zoom lenses with me, a 100 to 400 and a 12 to 60, because you're gonna be more invested in the moment. You're not going to be as distracted by carrying around your camera bag and trying to pick out different things. So travel with really casual gear that you can do a lot with. My second tip is to make a shot list or a plan. If you have a shot list and a plan, then once you fulfill your shots and once you actually complete your vision and you've gotten what you're happy with, you can put the camera away and you know that you're good. And if something really cool happens, like a whale pops up or there's like vultures that are flying around and ravens that are swooping into frame that look really cool, well, you can bring your camera out for that and capture those types of things on the fly. But as for things like people smiling and people looking at this tree or looking at that place and looking at the ocean and these really generic shots, plan these things out. Make sure that you have an idea. That way you're not doing this spray and pray technique. Not to say that the spray and pray technique is a bad one, but that's a really good thing when you're on set or when you have a job to do. By all means, do that. But when you're on vacation, that's not a smart move to do at all. And the last tip that I use and has helped me as I'm on this trip is to literally cut your day half and half. Maybe set your time aside and be like, you know what, for this half of the trip or this half of my walk, I'm going to be taking photos and videos. And the second half, I'm going to enjoy people's company and I'm going to enjoy the landscape. My suggestion is to make sure that you're enjoying your vacation first. And then secondly, take the photos and videos on the second half. This doesn't always work. This doesn't always happen because you might need to be capturing those moments before the light changes, or maybe half your group or half your friends and family are leaving halfway through the trip, so that doesn't really work because you want them to be included in your photos and videos. So sometimes you can't do that, but I really like doing this for a couple reasons. I tend to enjoy seeing what everything looks like, and I tend to get better footage because I know all the intricate details because I've spent time there. I'm not looking at it through a camera, and I have better memories of it because my first initial reaction was vacation. not camera. Now, I love my camera, I love this, but sometimes it's not appropriate or it's just not as enjoyable, and I regret using it when the time is not ideal. Anyway, those are just some of my tips and suggestions. I'm so sorry that this video is late, but I mean, I'm on vacation. Do you really blame me? Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and ring that notification bell so you're getting those notifications. You know, do all that jazz, and I will see you next time. Take care. But at the same time, I need to remember, and I need... But sometimes... I lost my train of thought. Now, here's some of my tips and suggestions to be... that I've... And that would really suck if my battery were to die before I actually...